In previous videos, we talked about the origins of the Socratic method, and how Socrates was trying to use this intense form of dialogue to awaken his fellow Athenian citizens to a more meaningful and reflective way of life. We talked about his student Plato and how he wrote his dialogues in attempts to help us internalize Socrates' wisdom and help us transcend our foolish and self-destructive behavior. Plato had a student to carry on his work, and that was Aristotle. Aristotle keeps this idea of seeing into things more clearly, and he transforms it. While Plato was pointing up and looking at a world which existed outside and independently of our own, often called the true world of pure forms, Aristotle is pointing down. He is more focused on this world and trying to make true statements about the fundamental causes of things. Aristotle was trying to create a theory of knowing. He wants to understand how we know what we know. Our modern world counts knowing as the ability to give an accurate description of something. If I asked you, do you know what a bird is? You would probably say yes. It has a beak, feathers, wings, and it flies. That is what makes up a bird, right? But what if I piled those parts, the beak and the feathers, onto a table and threw them up into the air so they were flying? Would people say, wow, what a beautiful bird? What's missing? There is some kind of structural, functional organization that makes up what we call a bird, and that is much harder for us to describe. We have no good word for this in English, so we will use the German word Gestalt, something that is greater than the sum of its parts. It is not the shape of a thing, but the way it is organized that makes it what it is. Aristotle thought that to know something was to grasp this Gestalt. It is understanding the essence of a thing. Who do you think knows more about a chair? Someone who can tell you every single fact about chairs, or someone who can make you a chair? Aristotle's form of knowing is the ability to cause something to be. He felt that when you know something, you share that same form in your mind. The carpenter has the form of a chair. Not just the shape, but this gestalt. He has the shape, function, and structural organization of a chair in his mind. This has sometimes been called the theory of conformity. When you conform to something, you share some part of its structural and functional organization within you. When I reach for a water bottle, my hand conforms to the bottle. There is a mutual fitting and belonging together that is happening. It is this fitting together that leads to Aristotle's idea of potential. Let's say we take a raw material, like wood. Wood can be made into a house, a chair, a ship, or a table. The wood is potentially all those things. But a house does not have nearly as much potential as wood, because it already has the actuality of a house. A ship is already a ship, a chair is a chair, and a table is a table. The same material of wood can be actualized in many ways. What is it that turns wood into something that acts like a house? Aristotle says it's the form. This is where we get our notion of information. Putting a form into something makes it what it is. These things have become actualized by giving the potential of wood a specific form and shape, so that it acts in a certain way. By seeing the potential of a thing, we can shape it into its fullest actuality. The more the architect informs himself on the art of building, the more he will be able to actualize his vision in the external world. Aristotle believed that everything was taking part in this process of actualization. He called this the final cause, or the ultimate purpose for why something is the way it is. He believed that the universe around us is acting on purpose, striving to reach its fullest potential and trying to come to completion. So that notion of Plato's we discussed, which says we have this deep desire to move towards a more harmonious way of being, Aristotle felt this applied to the entire universe. What this means is that if we are striving towards completion and the universe is doing the same, the organization of our mind and the organization of the world are the same. I'm not asking you to believe Aristotle was right, but simply to follow his line of thought. In this worldview, we are perfectly set up for a meaningful existence because there is a mutual fittedness between the mind and the universe the mind inhabits. Living organisms go through this same process of development, like a carpenter building a chair, except they do this in a self-organizing fashion. But our mind is not self-organizing in the same way that a plant is. There is an important difference. Unlike the plant, we are not only self-making, but we are also rational and reflective. We are capable of deliberately cultivating our own character like other organisms cannot. That is what Aristotle believed was our ultimate purpose, to cultivate virtue and regulate the growth of our character so we can actualize our potential in the fullest possible way. About 500 years later, a philosopher comes around who unifies the worldviews of Plato, Aristotle, and Socrates. In video 6, we will be moving on to Plotinus. If you guys enjoy the channel and want to help us create more high-quality content, please consider supporting us on Patreon or at our website, thinkbiganimation.com.